Hello, my name is Paul Weber. I'm the manager here at JEA Springfield Laboratory, welcoming you on our laboratory tour. And to get things started, this is Megan, who works up in our support area. Hi, Megan.
Hi.
And do you have to have that sample ready for me?
I do have that sample.
Great. Let's take a quick tour and find out where all the magic really happens. In our laboratory, we run thousands of tests every single month. Things ranging from drinking water, to wastewater, to groundwater, river water, even solid waste. Phew, I know. And we do all that to make sure that the things that we do don't harm the environment and or make your water not safe to drink. And now let's take the first stop on our tour, which is going to be into biology. Environmental stewardship, it's a fancy word, it just means taking care of the environment, and that's what we do here at JEA. And part of that in biology is we want to make sure that what we do doesn't have a negative effect on the environment. And one of the tests that we do here is we take the sample and we expose it to environmentally sensitive organisms to see how they respond. Three things we want them to do is be happy, eat lots of food, and make lots of babies. And the more they do that, the better off it is for the environment. While it is perfectly acceptable in the South to refer to our organisms as critters, just as one would raccoons or bears, I was informed we couldn't say critters in the video. Without further ado, here are the organisms used in our bioassay testing. Water flea, bannerfin shiner, inland silverside minnow, possum shrimp, fathead minnow, brine shrimp. Now, if you read comic books in the 1970s, you probably saw advertisements for sea monkeys. You excitedly sent them your or your parents' money, and instead of the cute little creatures in the advertisement, you got brine shrimp.
Sea monkeys, out now from moose.
Now that we're done with our tour of biology, let's head over to our main analytical lab. We do a variety of testing in this area, some of which is on solids. Some of the samples we have here are what's called poo in process. It's along the process path in the wastewater plant, and our operators get this information to make real-time decisions. So we may have an influent, which is what you flush down the toilet coming into our wastewater plant. The effluent, the final treated water that we may put into a pond or out for irrigation on a golf course, or in some cases, discharge into the river. We also have solid waste. Want to take a smell? This is poo in process called a sludge. This is after it's all been done. We actually will turn this into fertilizer for sale to the public. And other instrumentation we have here tests for a variety of other items in our sample, which could be nutrients such as phosphorus, nitrogen, and ammonia. Ammonia, nitrates, and phosphorus are good for your lawn and plants, but they aren't so good for the St. John's River. Here is a list of common items containing ammonia, nitrates, and phosphorus. Fertilizer, fireworks, detergent, LED lights, beets, sunflower seeds, explosives. All right, now that we've finished our tour of analytical, we're going to head over to microbiology. Let's head around the corner. Welcome to microbiology. And without going through a long list of Latin names that no one can pronounce, we do testing here on a variety of microbiological organisms. Now, they live in your intestinal tract and they help with the breakdown of food and absorption of nutrients into the body. And as long as they're in your body, they're fine. But once they get out into the environment, then it's not good for the environment and not good for humans to be out and around. So we do that with a number of tests here, and I'm going to illustrate that right now with one of our samples. So one of the tests we do involves pouring a sample into this pouch. We'll add some food to feed the organisms if they're present, and then we incubate the sample overnight. On the next day, we remove the pouch and we shine a black light and look for fluorescence. If the fluorescence is there, that means that the organisms are detected. And then we have a counting guide that allows us to determine how many colonies are present in the particular sample. We focus on two microorganisms that have a direct impact on human and environmental health, E. coli and pterococci. Welcome to Metals, and as the name implies, we test for metals in our samples. Here are some of the metals we test for in metals. Aluminum, copper, nickel, iron, gold, lead, lithium, zinc. And welcome to organics. In organics, we analyze for a plethora of analytes you find in everyday products. And my own personal opinion, growing up in this room, we've got the coolest toys, and we've got the Star Trek doors, and we play loud, obnoxious music. But I was told that we can't play loud, obnoxious music on a lab tour. But nonetheless, the names of many organic compounds can be rather tough to pronounce. To make it easier, here are some common items that contain organic compounds we test for. Paint, gasoline, nail polish, oil and grease, mothballs, medicine, gloves, motor oil. Well, that brings us to the end of our tour. Our friendly neighborhood sample and I want to say thank you for stopping by JEA and hope to see you out there sometime.